Hello, my name is Thomas Riele and I am application engineer at Volta Machines. In this tutorial, we would like to show you how to use our wheel probe.
We have created a standard end mill program with the Tool Studio Wizard to show you the operation and integration of the automatic measurement of grinding wheels. The grinding wheel probe has to be fully measured one time. This needs to be done with a reference wizard under the wheel probe. The wheel probe editor lets you enter the geometrical data as well as the axis positions X, Y, Z. These positions can be determined automatically with the addition of the setup gauge. Depending on the machine type, additional setup gauges might be necessary. Select the start button and the automatic cycle will determine the axis positions between the setup wheel and the touch probe. To integrate the measuring function, the plus symbol has to be selected. Then service. Then probe wheel. Followed by next. There we have to select the correct grinding wheel set and the desired wheel to be measured. The probe wheel operation can be added multiple times if several wheels need to be inspected. The probe wheel function is available for many wheel types. Now we will measure the 11V9 wheel of spindle 1 and would like to add a few comments to the parameter section. The diameter can be measured and compensated. Same with the length in Z. Additionally, the radius and angle can be measured, or to be exact, calculated from the previous collected data. The parameter execute only if wheel not probed provides the ability to completely measure the entire wheel if mounted for the first time. When this parameter is selected, frequency multiple will be grayed out and deactivated. At the end of the cycle, when the wheel was completely measured, it is noted in the wheel data that this wheel is now completed. If the function is repeated, it will not be measured again. If we would like to reset this to declare the wheel unmeasured, we have to go to the Common tab and select Reset All Wheels to Not Probed. Now we will deselect Execute Only if Wheel Not Probed and move on to Frequency Multiple. This parameter sets the cycle. For example, enter 10 if you only want to have the wheel re-measured after 10 grinding cycles. Here we set the amount of measuring points on the grinding wheel. It depends on the axial and radial runout of the wheel. I would recommend an amount between 4 to 8 points. Here we select the type of touch probe, stationary or swiveling. These two parameters enable slight corrections to the actual values if they need to be modified. Probing depth Y moves the measuring position at the grinding wheel end face. Probing offset Z moves the position in this direction on the side of the wheel. Generally, the maximum wheel diameter will be positioned into the center of the touch probe. These two parameters, diameter and length in Z, set the limit of the corrections. If within the limit, it corrects. If outside of the limit, it will display a message and no corrections will be taken. Now we will show you the entire cycle in the following details. First, the length will be determined roughly, then the diameter on four positions as set in the parameter. Next is the length position and a second position because we selected angle and radius as well. Now, the angle on the end face and OD positions are known. The measured diameter and the length in Z will now be imported into the wheel data. The angle and radius can be seen on the Tool Studio server. The measurement will be performed when we start the IDN. Because of the setting 10 in frequency multiple, the next 9 measurements will then be ignored.
I hope this tutorial can help you in your work with our machines and you are able to use our wheel probe. My colleagues and I will be happy to answer any questions you may have. You can find the contact details in the video description. Thanks for watching and best of success!